up, everyone? It's your girl Shay here, and I'm back with another video for you guys. And I am finally back with a brand new review for you guys, and it is on the fourth volume of the manga Crossmanaged. Now, as I stated before, Crossmanaged is a sports manga about a girls' lacrosse team. And it is about a main character by the name of Toyoguchi, who is on the girls' lacrosse team. But the lacrosse team at their school has like little to no structure. They lose all the time and they're just having a lot of fun basically playing. And Toyoguchi herself is not the best player, but she ends up meeting a guy by the name of Sakurai, who before actually used to play soccer, but due to an injury, no longer is able to play. So she basically recruits him to be the manager for the girls' lacrosse team at their high school. And the manga is pretty much about them gaining structure, starting to win some games, and along the way also each of the characters start to gain a lot more confidence in playing the game lacrosse and just forging their love for it. Now the fourth volume is pretty much about them going through their tournament against a national ranked team by the name of Chowron. Well, they're not exactly nationally ranked, but two of their players on the team, one of which his name is Namine, is actually a national player. She's on the national team. And Chowron Academy plays no games when it comes to going against other players. They are unbeatable. But the Toyoguchi's team is gonna give them a run for their money. So most of the fourth volume is about them training and learning about the Chowron team and how best to beat them at the game of lacrosse. There is another team that they also play at the beginning of the fourth volume, but they beat them fairly quickly because this team was also beat by Chowron, and because of that, their confidence is very, very low. So Toyoguchi's team is able to beat them pretty easily, so the main match is basically against them and Chowron. One of the things I do have to say that I did enjoy a lot about this volume is that you saw a lot of the gameplay, and it also was greatly combined with them training as well. Also with them training, you do meet or listen, not really meet, but you kind of read or learn more about the character Namine. Now, like I mentioned before, Namine is a national ranked player. She is on the national lacrosse team, but she has a weird way of how she feels about the game of lacrosse. She doesn't have a passion for the sport. She's just good at it, and that's basically how she feels about it. She just doesn't understand people who have a love for a sport that they lose at, or a love for a sport that they're not actually good at. And she has this conversation with Sakurai, the manager of the lacrosse girls team, and has this conversation with him, and he basically is deciding to show Namine that there's a lot more to the game of lacrosse besides just winning. You know, you got to have a love for it if you want to continue playing it. And for him, after seeing Toyoguchi, who at the time that he first met her wasn't very good at lacrosse, and seeing her gain more and more, not exactly confidence, but gaining more and more skill playing the game, and seeing her love for it shows him that having a love for the game, and also combined with his own like passion for soccer, he's like, he doesn't understand what Namine means, and he actually really wants to show her and the Chowron Girls Academy that you can still win and have love for a sport. But Namine is kind of in the whole thing of like crushing people's dreams, basically, or pretty much. But I really did, that's one of the things that I really, really did enjoy. And I have a couple of notes on my phone, so I forgive me if I'm looking down, like reading off of my notes. And also one of the things that I really like as well was that throughout the entire series, actually, you see Toyoguchi having fun playing the game of lacrosse. And one of the things though that I noticed is that she's still able to have fun playing the game of lacrosse while being able to admire the people that she is going against and admiring their skill for the game, even if she's losing against them, and even if they're opponent. And this is shown when they are finally playing against Chowron Girls Academy. And while playing, she actually asks Sakurai, hey, is it bad that I'm actually admiring Namine and how great she is playing? But I also did take a note of her like jealousy when Sakurai, no problem, actually says like, yes, she is a remarkable player. She actually ends up saying that she wants Sakurai to notice how good she's become and to actually be proud of her, which I'm sure that he is, but it, to me, that showed a little bit of jealousy and how she's like, you know what? I know that I'm an amazing player, and I'm gonna show you like just how great I've become. And it also showed though as well with like Toyoguchi admiring Namine that she never loses her like spirit or her demeanor. And but there is times during the manga so far that she like has gotten her spirits down and things like that, but she doesn't stay down for long. But overall, overarching for this particular volume, I overall really enjoyed it. I loved how you see the characters start playing better with each other. I liked seeing all the different plays that Sakurai came up with, such as Spear and Shield, which was a great way for them to try and win against Chaoran. And I'm excited to see where the fifth volume takes us. The fifth volume is actually the final volume in the cross-managed manga series. So I'm excited to see, will they win? Will they lose? What will they learn? What will the other characters, like the opponents, learn, such as Namine, because she has such this weird way of playing sports and with lacrosse in general. And overall, so far, I do recommend the series. To me, if you are a fan of other sports series like Prince of Tennis or Kuroko's Basketball or Slam Dunk or so on and so forth, I know there's quite a few sports shows out, then I definitely do recommend checking out Cross Managed. It is a lot less known compared to the other ones that I actually named, but I do feel like it does need some sort of respect, and it needs to be like put out that this is a good manga to read, especially since it is about a girls team, whereas opposed to the other ones I named are about boys sports or boys teams. Really, it's not so much about the girls as well, so I do recommend checking it out. And also, I will have to mention that while Kuroko's Basketball and especially Prince of Tennis do have her characters have like special moves and things like that, this does not. It doesn't say that any characters have any special moves that they do or anything like that. Yes, sometimes characters do spectacular moves during the manga, but they're not like superpowers or anything else like that. They're like just strictly just moves in general that are just amazing to watch, and that can actually happen in an actual game of lacrosse. So that is one thing that I will say, and I feel like most of this manga is about the coming together of a team and them learning to play together as a team and learning to be able to basically confront their fears and learn more about the game and enjoy playing the game in general. So definitely recommend checking it out. But that is my review on it. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I will have hopefully a new review on this in the next coming weeks. I do plan to have a review again next week, and that one I plan to actually have on an anime, which is going to be on the season 2 of My Hero Academia, which I'm doing in a different style compared to my previous reviews where I sit down and just talk about it. That one I do am going to talk about what I think of the show in general, like what I thought of season 2, but I'm also going to have a majority of it be a vlogging portion where I've, over the past week or so, have been vlogging myself watching the season 2 of My Hero Academia with my thoughts as the show is going along and seeing if I'm right or if I'm wrong or however. So it's a great way to see my like reactions kind of to the show, but not like reacting like a reacting channel, because I'm not going to have any visuals of the actual show because I don't want copyright infringement or anything else like that. But yeah, so look forward out to that review next Saturday. I should start editing that pretty soon since I'm almost through with season 2 of My Hero Academia. But of course, like always, I will leave links down below to all my social media accounts, Instagram, Twitter, blog as well. Please check it out down there. Mondays, this coming Monday, I should have a new Motivational Monday video for you guys, so I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Of course, if you have any topics you'd like me to discuss for those Mondays, please feel free to comment them down below, as well as comment any ideas that you guys would like me to discuss on this channel. Of course, on Wednesdays, I do an episode of Nerd News, so please check that out as well. And of course, like I always tell you guys, please stay positive, please, and stay nerdy as well. And of course, please subscribe if you haven't already and click the bell icon so you know if I'm going to come out with new videos. All right, you guys, that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys soon with the video. All right, you guys, bye.